Everyone to a new FIFA 22 tactics video on my channel. In this video I'm going to show you the best way to play with the national team of Brazil, and that is a bit different than normally because when you are going to online seasons, that's the videos that I'm making the most about online seasons, you can't play with the normal Brazilian squad, the real Brazilian squad. If you are going to online seasons and you're choosing Brazil, let's go and do that so you can see what's happening. There are not the real players in it. You can't get the real players in it because I think it's a license problem that FIFA doesn't have the right license for Brazil to use the real players. So let's change the team. Let's go to Brazil. And if you see, there are all these fake names. So yeah, you can play with this, but that's not that fun, of course. They are not really good, as you can see, all around the 80 rated, so that's not super good for an all-star team. So that's not what you want to play, in my opinion. You want to play with the real players, but the only way that you can do that is in offline modes. And offline mode is like if you're going to play the quick modes, and they can do kickoff. So if you are at home and you have some friends around and you want to play some matches and you want to play with Brazil, then you can play with the real Brazilian players. But you need to do something for that. You go to customize. I'm going to show you this. You go to customize. Then you go to edit teams. And then you go to national squads. Then you're choosing Brazil. You can also do this for other teams, of course, but in all the other teams are the real players, and in Brazil not. But if there is a player injured and he was not in the squad the last match they played, then they are not in the squad, and you can switch them like I'm going to do with the Brazil squad as well. So if you're seeing here on the left side, you see all these fake players, and on the right side you see all the real players. So what you're gonna do, selecting this onions, and then you're gonna switch for another goalkeeper, Alisson at for an example. Then we have Perez, then you want Edison, of course. And so you can do that with all the players. So we want Neymar in the squad, of course. Then we need to go back up. I think two goalkeepers is enough. You don't need three goalkeepers. Then we go and choose the defenders. Thiago Silva, Felipe, Alex Sandro, Militao is a really good defender. With L1 and L1 you can switch to the other side, to the next page, I need to say. Militao is already there, and then we need to replace this one. What is a good defender? We have Telles. Okay, I think we have enough defenders now. Then we can go for the midfielders. Casemiro, really good one. Fabinho, really good one, of course. We already have two defensive midfielders. I think that is enough. We do Firmino, who's a center forward, but I want him in the squad as well. Alan is a really good defensive midfielder. We can have Paulinho, who's a good central midfielder. Let's put him in the squad as well. So you can choose whoever you want. It doesn't matter that much. You could pick your favorite players, but yeah, in my opinion, you want the best players, of course. Who else should we pick? Let's pick well, it doesn't matter that much. Let's take Fred. Then we go to the strikers. Gabriel Jesus, Richarlison, we can put in the squad. Talisca, who else do we have? We have also Lodi, but we already have two really good left defenders. Oscar is maybe a really nice player to have in the squad as well. Who else should we pick? Lucas Moura, really fast player. And then last but not least, let's pick Vinicius Junior. Then I'm going to take a look at the bit lower rated players. If we miss someone, I don't know. I don't think so. I think this is good. All right. Oh, maybe Anthony. Anthony is a really good player as well. From Ajax, of course. Let's pick him. Just for fun. All right. If you are ready, when you have selected all the right players that you want to have, then you press the option button to submit the squad. And then you're going back to the team sheets. No, not to the team sheets. You're going back to the main menu, and then you're going to the play, and then for an example, take quick mode, take kickoff. And then we do a classic match. And if you then select Brazil, and if you don't do anything now and you pick them, you will still have the Unreal players, if you're gonna see now. Look, you still have the Unreal players. Then we're going back. What you need to do is press triangle. Live form on is on by default. If you're pushing triangle, it's putting live form off. And when you are doing that, then you get the players that you selected yourself. If you're going to the team management, then you see Neymar, Jesus, Rapinha, Paulinho, Casimiro, Fabinho, whoever you want, they are there. So you need to put the live form off. All right, then I made a formation, and this is the formation that I like to play with Brazil the most. I only checked it out in offline modes, of course, because you can't play with them in online mode. So it's only offline. I played against a friend, and yeah, for me, it did a really amazing job. We're using the formation, the 3-1-4-2 formation. Then we have the lineup. Alisson is the goalkeeper. We have Militao, Marquinhos and Diego Carlos as the three center backs. Then we have one defensive midfielder, and that is Fabinho. Casimiro and Roberto Firmino are the central midfielders. On the right side, I choose Moura. On the left side, Vinicius Jr. Two strikers. We're using Neymar and Gabriel Jesus. On the bench, we have Edison, Felipe, Oscar, Paulinho, Alan, Fred and Anthony. Anthony is a really, really nice one to have on the bench. You can also switch Rapinha if you want another fast player on the bench. Doesn't that matter that much? Edison, who needs a second goalkeeper on the bench? No one has ever used that, I think. So maybe you can switch that. Two fast players on the bench is really nice to have. You have Fred, who is a good midfielder to bring in the second half. Paulinho as well. So you have much, much to choose. We're going to the tactics. I choose press after possession loss with a width of 50 and a depth of 60. So we're playing really attacking football with only three defenders, five midfielders, two strikers. We're going to press if we lose the ball, because you have that much attacker. So it's really hard for your opponent to pass the ball around if you are going to press immediately after you lose the ball. With 60, you're really high on the pitch, so there's not much space for your opponent to pass the ball around. Then we have build up play. I choose balanced. You can also do fast build up or a long ball if you want, but your players are going to make lots and lots of meters on the field, especially when you lose the ball. They are going to press, and if you have the ball and they're also going to run forward that much, they will be getting tired really soon. So I choose balanced for this one, and the chance creation is direct passing. The width is 60, plays in the box 5 bars, corners and free kicks both 2 bars. Then the instructions. All players have aggressive interceptions. I already said it in videos before. I like this setting that much because, for my feeling, the players are taking the ball back much easier. They are aggressive on the ball. They are not making any falls, in my opinion. So you don't get much free kicks again with this setting. But they are, yeah, reacting quicker, tackling more aggressive, and for my feeling, you get the ball back more easy than when you have this on normal, or on this one I never tried, but normally I had it on normal. But with aggressive interception, I think this is doing a wonderful job. So every player has this on with me. All the other things for the center backs are just default. Then we're going to Fabinho. He's the most defensive midfielder. So cut passing lanes, stay back while attacking, aggressive interceptions, of course, and cover center. Then we have Casimiro, balanced attack, stay on the edge of the box for the cross and aggressive interceptions. I have him on cover wing because we are only playing with a right midfielder and a left midfielder. We don't use fullbacks. So when Moura is going to attack and you lose the ball, there's nobody on the right side. So then you need Casimiro to fill up that gap on the right side of the field for when your opponent is going to attack on his left side. So Casimiro is filling up that gap and try to pick up the left winger or the left midfielder of your opponent on that moment. Firmino is playing more attacking. He's a central forward, of course. So get forward, get into the box for the cross. Aggressive interceptions. The same for him. Stick with the cover wing. When Vinicius Jr. is forward and Firmino is not, he can fill up the gap on the left side. So your opponent is not having a freeway on the right side of his attack to run forward. He will fill up that gap. Then we're going to Moura, come back on defense because you're not playing with fullbacks. Stay wide, get in behind, and aggressive interceptions. Then on the left side, the same for Vinicius Jr. Come back, stay wide, get in behind, and aggressive interceptions. Then we have Gabriel Jesus. Stay central and aggressive interceptions is the only thing I changed for him. And Neymar, the only thing is get in behind and aggressive interceptions. All right, this is it. This is how you can put the real players into the Brazilian squad. This is how I like to play with them. And yeah, if you are want to play yourself, you can only use this in offline modes, as I already said. So if you have friends around that want to play, or maybe you go in a career and you are getting going to be the coach of the national team of Brazil, maybe you can use this as well. This is the end of this video. Thank you very much for watching. Have a great day. Bye bye.